Grandpa Joe. Maybe you should accompany Charlie. If you think you can handle it.
Handle it? You just try to stop me!
I never thought I'd see the day when I would face the world and say good morning. Look at the sun. I never thought that I could be flat on the lap of luxury. Cause I have said it couldn't be done.
But it can be done.
Yes, it can be done.
He never had the dare to think that there would be a golden time to make the glorious golden twin for a hundred becomes sublime.
Gentlemen, welcome to the Willy Wonka Chocolate Factory, where history is about to be made. You are all going to meet the chocolate genius of the century. And here he is now, Mr. Willy Wonka.
Welcome, welcome, my little friends, to my factory. Augustus Gloop, please step forward.
Who's that golden nugget, Mr. Wonka?
I always thought a verruca was a wart, but you don't look like a wart. More of a mole, or perhaps a bunion.
How are you doing, Wonka? Salt the name, and I'm nuts. An operation like this goes for $1,000,000.
Make that $1,000,001. Your ticket, please.
Here's your silly ticket. Can I have it back after the toll?
Of course you can, my dear. Of course. Violet Beauregard?
I hear ya.
Here's our ticket.
Violet, there's no gum chewing allowed on the tour.
But you make gum.
Violet, Mr. Wonka asked you to remove your gum. Do we need to negotiate? Psychobabble, whatever. Eyes on the prize, Violet. Eyes on the prize.
Mike TV? Mike TV and guests?
Hold your pantyhose, Mom! I'm about to be this level.
Here's our ticket, Mr. Wonka.
Scrumptious. Oh, and Mike, there's no Wi-Fi on the tour.
None?
None whatsoever. Chuck Bucket.
It's Charlie. Charlie Bucket. Here's our ticket.
So you're Charlie Bucket. Odd coincidence, you finding this ticket just in time.
Now see here, Mr. Wonka, if you're saying our ticket is a phony.
And pleased to meet you too, mister.
You know me, Wonka.
Do I? Well then, let's proceed. We start with the contract. Please raise your right hand. I hereby swear not to touch, malign, assign, clutch, share, wear, or tear, none such party of the first part, and so on. Please sign below.
No, not my lawyer. Oh, let me give him a ring.
There is no cell phone reception.
Where do I sign?
Welcome to the chocolate smelting room, where thousands of miles of copper pipe twist beneath the earth, carefully chilling the chocolate to a precise temperature, perfect for dipping strawberries. Augustus, no matter how tempting, and isn't it deliciously tempting, you must not touch the chocolate. It will instantly harden like cement.
Look! Over there! It's some sort of creature! Freeze! Put your hands where I can see it, Pop!
No need to worry. That, my friends, is an Oompa Loompa.
A zombie worker!
Not a zombie worker, a refugee.
From where, Wonka?
All my workers are Oompa Loompas from Loompa Land.
Now, see here, Wonka, I teach geography and
then
I...
Then you should know all about Loompa Land, with its thick jungles infested by hornswogglers and snazzy wangers and those vicious wangdoodles.
Wangdoodles? There's no such thing.
They're sure are, my dear. And a wangdoodle would just love to sink its sharp, vicious fangs into you. Augustus! My chocolate must never be touched by human hands.
Great. Now he's going to give his coal to millions of people.
It's so good. I think I have two with us in chocolate.
Poor Augustus. Take Mrs. Gloop's poop to the strawberry dipping room. Goodbye, Mrs. Gloop, and good luck. Please follow along as we continue our tour. Part of our journey by boat. Please step up and in. Watch your step. Violet, do not lick the boat. You'll only make the ship sticky.
But where are you taking us?
There's no knowing where we're going. There's no earthly way to go. So we're the south, the wind is blowing. To the north, there may be snow. To the west, the moon is glowing. To the east, a cock may crow. So we show no signs of slowing. Someone must know where we are, but no destination. Showing, so it's all a bit bizarre.
Though our mood is easy going,
like a game of tic-tac-toe, we must seize this dilly-dallying,
shilly-shallying to and fro.
It's no mystery where we're going, unlike Edgar Allan Poe, quite apart from our not knowing. This next room is the most important room in the entire factory. My most secret inventions are cooking and simmering in here. Voila! The everlasting gourmet gobstopper.
It looks like gum.
That's because it is gum.
Gum?
The most dazzling gum in the entire world.
Gum? Oh no.
An entire gourmet meal without any of those nasty calories.
Oh.
Unfortunately, it is not perfected yet, so we must not chew it.
Gum? I only have one dream in life. There's very little to it. Chew one stick of life on gum and all I want to chew it. Chew it all through childhood. I'll chew it when I'm wed. If I survive till 95, I'll chew it till I'm dead.
But this gum here is much different than that one. This gum here is a three-course dinner. Pea soup, roast beef, and blueberry ice cream. Blueberry is the nicest ice cream. You may feel fat, but in fact, you're thinner, even after a three-course dinner.
The gum is so mine! It really tastes like pea soup. And here comes the roast beef, so tender and juicy.
But the blueberry ice cream?
I bet it's to die!
That's what I'm worried about. The dye.
Yo, Violet, you're so busted.
That gum is gonna do it.
Her candy paint on down the drain.
I asked her not to chew it.
Too late, Billy, not to chew it, because I know just how to do it. There's no need to poo-poo it. All I have to do is do it.
Violet, it's so bad for you.
Yo, Violet, dude, you're turning blue.
three good little children left.
Mr. Wonka, will Violet be all right, or will she be a blueberry forever?
Very probably. Now come along. There's so little to see in so much time. Stop. Reverse that. And welcome to the fizzy lifting drink room.
Bubbles? Do they taste like candy? Mr. Wonka, I want bubbles that taste like candy.
Actually, the bubbles taste like soap for children with dirty mouths. It's what the bubbles do that is remarkable.
What do they do, Wonka?
Just one taste of my fizzy lifting drink, and you will float on air.
Float on air? Whoa!
Unfortunately, my legal advisors have forbidden our taking even the tiniest taste. Now come along, I've more exciting things to show you.
Mr. Wonka? Kids?
They've left us behind.
Grandpa Joe? What's that? Hello? Who's there?
Should we?
Well, I guess one little taste won't do any harm. Whoa! I'm flying!
Me too, Charlie! Wow!
Whee!
Woohoo!
Whoopee! Woohoo! Whoopee! Woohoo!
What's that sound?
I don't know. It's getting louder, though. We better float down.
Look up, Charlie. It's a fan. It's sucking us up. Try to float down.
I can't!
Try, Charlie. Try!
I can't!
Oh, it's gonna cut us to bits!
See?
That's it! Burping's the answer!
This is fun!
Come on, Charlie. Let's get back to the group.
You see, Veruca, cocoa beans contain a variety of chemicals, the primary psychoactive components being theobromine and caffeine. Now just come along and... Charlie, do stay with the group. We wouldn't want you to float away now, would we? And next we have the Nut Room.
Wonka are squirrels.
They sure are squirrels. Eventually, these squirrels will remove a walnut from its shell in one piece and at the same time sort the good nuts from the bad nuts.
Squirrely, squirrely, they're so adorable.
Veruca, whatever you do, do not disturb the squirrels. They're in training.
See here, Wonka. I want a squirrel. I want a squirrel and I want to squirrel everything can boat. And while we're at it, I want a feast. I want a bean feast. Cream buns and donuts and fruit cakes with no nuts. So good you can go nuts. Give them to me. Now I want a party with roomfuls of laughter. I want a ton of ice cream. And if I don't get the things I I
Place the goggles over your eyes. Fantastic. And welcome to the Coco Vision Room.
What is this place? Some sort of television studio?
Of course, for making Wonka commercials.
Wrong. You are all familiar with how television works?
Yeah. Big deal. What's this thing do?
I'm sorry. I'm a bit deaf in that ear.
I said...
What's this thing do?
I'm a bit deaf in that ear as well.
What's the loompty doompty doing?
You see, television gave me a wonderful idea. If you can send a picture via television, why not a candy bar?
That's impossible.
It's very possible. Imagine sitting at home watching TV, and you see a commercial. Try a Wonka bar, try it now! And poof, there it is! A simple touch of that button right there. Unfortunately, it's not perfected yet, so we must not touch it.
Hey! Watch me! I'm gonna be the first person to send back television!
Look! Something's happening!
Hey! Look at me! I'm on TV!
He's completely unharmed!
Unharmed? He's barely 6 inches tall!
Yes, well, that is a problem. But small boys can be very springy and stretchy. Ah, the taffy pulling machine. That should work well.
How far do you think he'll stretch?
Who knows? Maybe miles.